Here is part two of the mixed bag. This is Scott Swope talking about fitness.
I think for people that are trying to lose weight, you know, you just have to really watch the carbs, things like that, and make sure you're, if you have the time, but if you can do something for a half an hour a day, I think that's a step in the right direction.
Another factor is having the time for meal prep. Are you good about making stuff and putting it into Tupperware?
No, I'm very lucky. I am very lucky because I have a wife that does all that for me. So I'm cheating. I'm sorry. She does everything as far as that goes. I'm not a good cook, other than I can cook a mean breakfast, or I can make oatmeal with a protein shake. All my breakfast stuff I can do myself, but she's really good at getting me the right meals and everything that I need.
This is Loretta Burnett talking about John Witherspoon.
I was at the comedy club, oh God, what's the name of it? The Funny Bone in Virginia. And I think on one side of me was my then pregnant niece. We all went and we got to meet him. He was funny. He had us laughing while we were taking the picture. So yeah, I met a few comics through that way too, you know, just by going to the comedy club.
That's so cool. You got to meet him. I remember him in movies and I was sad when he passed away.
Yeah, that was very sad because he was a funny guy. When he passed, Bernie Mac, I was like, oh my God, funny guys. But, you know, I guess they did their job and it was time for them to go. But they left us a lot of laughs.
This is Jack Leary talking about being a pet parent.
We have Fiona, the French bulldog.
Oh, darling.
She's my leading lady. She runs the circuit and does her own entertainment. But yeah, as a matter of fact, I asked Chris Schaefer, it would be cool that I bring along a four-legged friend. And he's like, yeah, man, rock it out. So he's cool. I mean, he put on a good show and it's all different styles. There was like a skateboard dude and it's his stuff. You know, he decks it out kind of edgy. We got this guy, Bowtie Bob, and he's like 80-some years old and he gets all snazzed out. But yeah, I took Fiona down the runway. Yep. And she just looked around and kind of strutted her stuff. Nobody was looking at me.
This is Don A. Douglas talking about theater.
I've done Amadeus. I was one of the Vinticelli's community theater. I also had to memorize another Vinticelli's lines because he had a habit of mixing up lines or forgetting lines. One of the last shows or whatever is like the last act four. We're almost done. And so the Vinticelli that I had to memorize for too, he is saying his lines and he jumped ahead and I hear on my right side, no. And I bust out laughing because he knew that he jumped. We all knew he jumped ahead.
This is Steve Soto talking about comedies.
Everything Jim Carrey, Ace Ventura.
Liar, Liar?
Well, yeah, I love Liar, Liar. He's done so many. Cable Guy, the other one, actually my favorite one, I watch it all the time, religiously. Like I can watch it on repeat all the time, is Dumb and Dumber. If you watch Jim Carrey act in detail, you'll see why I love him so much. He's just like, every little thing he does, it's just like, it's reality, but exaggerated. When I had started watching comedy, it's a lot of the inappropriate ones that I was into, like Road Trip or Old School, you know, the stuff that's like, inappropriate.
This is Dan Berkman with advice for comedians.
I would advise doing as many gigs as you can before the actual one that you really don't care about, so you get used to it. Start small. I don't go for the big kahuna. When I was doing stand-up the first time, it's, oh, Dan, don't worry about it. There's nobody here. You know, and that's how it was. And when we got there, it was like, I don't know, like four of us. It was like, oh, eight people. All right, I can do this. In about 20 minutes, it was 80 people. I was like, oh, my God. You know, and I was like, ooh. You know, I knew my material was good because I ran it so many times. You know, I knew my jokes were good, and I did get a good response. But it was, like, intimidating. But when you start doing it so many times, it becomes not so much of a big deal. Like, this is what you get.
This is Lisa Spanagle.
How do you deal with not knowing where you stand after an audition?
Well, you have to understand, I feel, is you can be the best person in the room and still not get booked. You can literally be the absolute best actor that they've seen and not get booked, mainly because you don't fit the part. And you could have done really perfectly, but you don't look like the person that they want, you know, to have there, or you look too much like somebody they've already cast.
This is Jesse Milliner on Marvel.
Well, I know the whole San Diego Comic-Con thing with Robert Downey Jr. as Dr. Doom, at least so we think. I know it looked like he was, but I'm still kind of hoping that he's not. I love Robert Downey Jr., don't get me wrong. I love him as Iron Man. But Dr. Doom is such an important character to Marvel. I feel like we should give the mantle of that role to someone who we haven't seen yet as an actor. That's just my two cents.
This is Adriana Sturdivant. What are your hobbies?
So I like to sew. I'm very slow. Takes me forever. And I crochet. Years ago, when I lived in England, my friend's mum crocheted, and she taught me and my friend how to do it. And I just like doing it just when I'm sitting watching TV. Actually, I like them for different reasons. When you're sewing, I have to concentrate, especially if I'm following a pattern. And the crocheting I like because you don't have to concentrate, and it's kind of a little bit like you're meditating, you know, that just repetitive motion.
That was it for season 2. Come back for more Cielo Vision this winter. Subscribe to get the alerts.